Hey everyone, it's Dr. Lisa Holland, and I am talking hips today. So I started, one of the things I do is I train people in yoga immersion. First 5 modules or so of this 9 modules is really for personal exploration, and then we get into a little bit more in-depth techniques of body readings and things like that to use if they want to go on for a teacher training. So I thought I'm gonna combine two things and start giving some of these extra tips and helps that I give them for their own bodies in the trainings, while also helping people on my Belly Guru LLC page who might be working through their yoga and wanting to understand their body. So you get some freebies here. So I hope that you will join me. So today we're going to be talking about hips, and the hips are in my physical therapy realm, really important for stabilizing the body. I think we understand that, we've got two parts of the hip. We're looking at the pelvic bowl, and then we've got that leg bone that comes in. Okay, so we have lots of things going on. We have lots of joints. We have this, there's some movement here in this pubic symphysis that controls in here. There's some connection here between not only the main spine coming up and through the torso, but this triangle bone that you can feel right in your low back. A lot of people know the SI joints, sacroiliac joints. So that's where it connects into these two side bones, the ilium, the sacroiliac joint. There's some ligaments there. There's a lot of bands of ligaments in here. I welcome you to search, Sri Google Nanda as my doc, as my teacher, Dharma Mitra always says, go look at Google Nanda. So, but you can see a picture of it, and we've got all these muscles going in. We've got muscles that connect along with body parts and things that are inside the pelvis. The inside the pelvic floor, the sides of the pelvic floor, we've got muscles that come out through here and actually connect into that bone for a better perspective. So that person that says, "Ooh, I've got a piriformis problem," is talking about this muscle that comes just like these fingers on me to the side of the bone in that butt muscle. But sometimes it's a pelvic floor that feels like a piriformis because it's actually the obturator internus, an inside muscle of the pelvic floor support that is also navigating some control through this hip. So why are we talking about this with yoga? Well, you move your hips, or at least you should move your hips, and a lot of people are moving them other areas such as the spine or a lot in the knees. If you look at the leg bone, so if I can't move here at my hip and move this top bone, you know what I'm gonna do? There's a kneecap in the bottom leg and the side leg there and the foot. I'm gonna start twisting here. And you know what? Not supposed to do that. In a little bit of the end extension, it locks in the joint for you to have your legs straight, but it overall is not really supposed to be happening, especially if you're in bent leg, such as Warrior One with that front leg bent. Okay, we really don't want any of this going on. We have those cruciate ligaments. If you know anybody that tore their ACL or PCL, they crisscross just like this in there. Ain't very good for that. Obviously, the ankle will accommodate. If your foot's really rigid, a really rigid foot, that high, hard arch, or really flat where it's not having any spring support, you can see where that's going to go all the way up the chain and into those hips. So the fact that this hip has part of it be this bowl is basically a four-way intersection for it. It's basically allowing it to have this force transmission from the lower body to the upper body. And it really is a very complex mechanism. So as much as you want to work fast and move really free and run and jump and do all of these things, if you are somebody who really hasn't become aware of their body, their different body parts, then this can actually cause quite a problem, because there's so many places you can get movement if you don't have movement someplace else, and that can cause some dysfunction. Therefore, if this bone is twisting in here as opposed to here because you're stiff in your spine, or maybe you're really loose here and instead of, and you're really stiff in your pelvis, and so you're moving from warrior one to warrior two, but your pelvis isn't doing it. So what I'm seeing as the teacher or the educator is I'm seeing a lot of rib motion. So how would that look? So I can functionally, I'll show you my hips, my pelvis, okay? I can functionally see that in how they stand. Okay, so I'm seeing the person. Can they square off or can they straighten out through their hips? That's a nice indication to me that if their pelvis is open and they're in warrior one, their body's forward and their hips are not, I might either one, they don't have awareness in having motion here, or they just really don't have motion. Again, in order for that pelvis to move, I need to have rotation be able to happen here at the hip bone going into the socket here of the pelvis. If that doesn't happen, if I'm very tight in muscles coming from these bottom bones into the inner thigh, those adductors, if I'm really that IT band has a lot of fibrous tissue, if I'm held kind of out here, if my side muscles are really weak and I'm not stabilizing the pelvis, you see where I can relatively be locking in this joint and causing all sorts of angles that are not conducive to those warrior ones and warrior twos. So that's why it's really great that if you are having some pains or strains, if you're new to yoga, finding someone who's educated in the physical body, if you can find a physical therapist, such as myself, who's a yoga therapist as well, that's really ideal. If you don't have that, working with your physical therapist to maybe find some of these things and then bringing that to your yoga educator. And hopefully he or she is well versed in the physical functional anatomy. And if not, then seeking out that maybe yoga therapist and had some more education, or those licensed healthcare providers such as myself, or a massage therapist, or an occupational therapist that utilizes yoga in their program, but has this really profound understanding of all of this kinematics and kinesiology. So where else can we see about the hip? So that's a big one in terms of rotation not happening at the hip, and therefore excess happening at the spine. Sometimes what's going on is that we have, if we can imagine, you know, this is the front and this is the back. If we hang out kind of tucked under, I can have some issues. Sometimes I'll see that with a pregnant person, okay, or somebody that was pregnant. They're kind of standing like this because the belly was up front for a while, and that's how, you know, maybe they didn't have enough strength to really hold themselves up, or the baby just was riding really far forward, or they're holding kids all the time. I see that in weight trainers. I see that in CrossFitters. Sometimes, you know, they're really strong up front, or they have really short abs from doing workouts, but the pelvis is not moving, or the spine has been held straight as opposed to its natural lordotic or curve. All of that can impact the pelvis, therefore all of that can impact the hip joint. So I'm speaking of that as that total area, because in reality, especially when we're working through yoga poses, we're working as one whole unit. We're moving and bending forward, bending back, working in a rotation, possibly working in a bend forward and then a rotation. So it's really understanding that how these segments work together. So if I have that sort of posture on the hip joint itself, what ends up happening is on this socket, okay, there's this little lip of cartilage, kind of like the end of your nose. Okay, it doesn't go completely around, it's about three quarters around, and it deepens this a little bit, similar to the labrum that we have in our shoulder. We have a labrum in our hip socket. And if I'm somebody who tucks under, I may cause this to be like hang forward in here all the time, and I can cause there to be wear and tear and stretching of that labrum from the inside. And then what ends up happening is if I'm doing something, let's say, is hip extension, Okay, so let's say I'm going into a lunge. I normally hang out in this sway back posture. Sometimes the models do that, or the girls now do that to look nice and thin in their Instagram photos. If I'm hanging out like that, already technically in a hip extension, and then I'm going into, let's say, a lunge, a deep lunge, and again, I'm hanging. I'm not really supporting or moving that bone. A lot of times, people who hang end up getting weak in their butt muscles, weak in their pelvic floor merely because it's shortened and tightened. Then I can't functionally use that power as well. I'm not going to end up pulling that bone back in the socket. I may cause it to the head to shove forward. Then I can start doing things like labral tears, or dislocations a little bit, or subluxations where it comes out a little bit, it's a little loose in the joint, and I actually have an instability. And when I have an instability, now I got to really work on some other muscles giving me stability in certain things, such as force power for the core and things like that. So we start to see other compensations come. So that's where it's important in positional. We want to be in a nice neutral positioning of the pelvis from that natural curve of the spine. All right, there's a million things I can talk about. I'm sure I'm going to come back and speak more, but I want to talk about those two things because I think that lunges are really prevalent, and watching our lunges in yoga class are important in getting help on. You should be feeling your butt muscles work in a lunge, in a deep lunge. You should be feeling the spine pull up and out. You should be feeling your inner thighs and leg muscles working to support you. You're not just hanging there. And in that warrior one, warrior two transition, that really needs to happen at the pelvis and hips, not really just at the spine. All right, take care. Let me know below if any of this was helpful. If you have any questions in terms of specific movements, I'll be looking at this in the future to try to keep up with that. Or you, as always, you can contact me at bellyguru.com. Put in our contact page. Tell me the episode that you were talking about, and I'll get back to you personally. Take care. Have a good day.